I thought I'll move to the next point, but before that, I remembered that we also wrote a word called realized yield. You remember? We had also written a term called realized yield. Ex-post. A standalone sum on realized yield has not come in the exam. Standalone, you understand, separate sum. But realized yield has been tested in one paper as a part of a big sum. So right now I cannot do that big sum because it contains other portions of risk analysis. But I can at least teach you realized yield, giving my own example so that the knowledge has gone into you and that sum can come when we do other portions. Good? So we are moving into what? Realized yield. It is point number 8. 9? Point number 9. Just once again. Point number 9. Realized yield. Bracket RY. Okay, listen. What is the full form of YTM? Yield to maturity. If you try to stay in that full term, yield to maturity. If we stop over here, yield. Yield means what are we earning on the price? To maturity. That's a very strange word. It means YTM is assuming that you are going to hold the bond till when? Maturity. YTM is assuming that if you buy a 10-year bond, you cannot sell it in between. Because the name is yield to maturity. It's assuming that you are going to get the bond, hold the bond till maturity. This is realistic or unrealistic? Unrealistic. I can sell the bond after 7 years. Can I? Yes. Are you okay with this? Secondly, even if we consider, okay, we'll hold the bond till maturity, suppose, then you will feel that, sir, then YTM is okay. If somebody is saying that he will hold it till maturity, then also it's not okay. Because the intermediate cash flows, say 14% coupon, 1000 face value, 140 first year, 140 second year, what is happening to the 140 realistically? What are we doing of the 140? Obviously, we are reinvesting. If you buy the bond today and you get 140 after 1 year, then second year 140, are you putting it in the Almira? No, nobody. You are reinvesting. YTM assumes that we are reinvesting at YTM. Reinvesting at YTM. Whereas, at what rate will you reinvest the 140 after 1 year? It depends upon the rate at that time in the market. When I get 140 after 1 year, what will be the rate in the market at which I can reinvest? God knows. After 2 years when I get 140, what will be the rate in the market? God knows, I don't know. Realized yield means what? No assumption. They will tell you, you bought a bond at 972. You bought when? 7 years ago. When? 7 years ago. You got 140, 140 every year, which you reinvested at 16%. Reinvested at 16%. It was a 10-year bond and you sold it after 7 years. You sold it after 7 years, which means when 3 years were left. It was a 10-year bond. You sold it after 7 years when 3 years were left. So the selling price at the end of 3 years, suppose I am selling the bond to you. After 7 years, I am selling the bond to you. Why are you buying the bond? After 7 years, I am selling the bond to you. Why are you buying the bond? To enjoy the next 3 years cash flow. To enjoy the next 3 years cash flow. So the price of the bond at the end of 7 years, P7, is equal to the present value of the cash flow of the 8th year, 9th year, 10th year. Price of the bond at any point of time is the present value of the remaining cash flows. You are buying the bond at the end of 7th year to enjoy the future cash flow. What are the future cash flow? 8th year, 9th year, 10th year, pulled to 7th year. In fact, I should say, when we are standing at 7, that's the 0th point of time. Okay? Who gave this dialogue? I think Amitabh Bachchan, na? Ki main jahan khada hota, wahin se line start hoti hai. Okay, that dialogue. So wherever he stands, wherever we stand, that's the 0th point of time. So if we are standing after 7 years, That is zero. And the price over there is the present value of the remaining 3 years, discounted at the yield in the market then. Discounted at the yield in the market then. What is the yield in the market then? So they will have to tell us everything. Now they will tell us everything. What happened? You bought at what price? Okay, you got the cash flows. You reinvested at what price? When did you sell? At what price did you sell? If they will tell you everything, you will do outflow equal to inflow and calculate what? R, that's realized yield. So I'm trying to say realized yield has no assumption. YTM is based on assumption about you'll hold the bond till maturity and you'll keep on reinvesting all the cash flow at the rate of what? YTM. For those who have done Forex, for those who have done Forex, in the last class or second last class, I don't remember, of Forex, I had given some homework. Okay? In that homework, there was some on Nepalese currency. Nepalese currency. And in the Nepalese currency, some international capital budgeting, one person asked me a doubt that, sir, you had not taught us MIRR, modified internal rate of return. Remember? Modified internal rate of return, MIRR. Then I taught you that in MIRR, we have to send all the cash flows of the project at the end and then do outflow equal to inflow. Realized yield is like MIRR. Realized yield is like MIRR. Now, if I am sitting at your place, if I am sitting over there and I listen to this word, says talking about MIRR, yes, I can remember, I am not able to remember it totally. I will get the stress and I will today only go home and see once MIRR where it was. That sort of attachment to the class has got to be there. That everything he's saying about NBFC. Let me just spend some time into NBFC fiasco. So much article has been written, a small summarized article. So you will have to see how are you differentiating yourself from the masses that you have to see. Okay? So there the difference is created when one person is so much attached to the classes, so much passionate about the classes, wants to just build a career out of every chapter. Okay? It's not easy, other obligations are also there, but that's what differentiates. Okay, but for that you have to take it not as a responsibility, but as a likeliness. I'm liking this stuff, yes. I'll see it, what's happening in the bond market. How can I invest in bonds? Bond mutual fund, what are they, what are not they? Because we can't keep on telling all that in class, now in the normal rhythm. Okay, realized yield. Write down, please. YTM is criticized as it is a promised yield. It is a promised yield. Look at the word promise. It is a promised yield. And unfortunately, the promise is generally not fulfilled. The promise is generally not fulfilled. Are you getting the dialogue? It's a promised yield. It's telling us you buy the bond at this price, you will get this return, but you don't get that return. The promise is not fulfilled. Bracket. To be elaborated in risk analysis section. To be elaborated in risk analysis portion. To be elaborated in risk analysis portion. Risk analysis portion. Bracket close, full stop. So I cannot elaborate that right now. Why is the promise not fulfilled and all that stuff? I cannot elaborate because if I do that, I'm totally diverting. I'll do that in risk analysis, na? So I've just given you the hint. Okay, YTM is not something which is reliable. It's very, very risky. Okay? In fact, do you remember when I told you the chapter layout yesterday? In that case, I told you about active versus passive management. Part 3. Part 2 is risk analysis. Part 3, active versus passive. In active management, we want to beat YTM. We want to beat YTM. YTM is 14%. We are saying that I have the caliber that I will earn more than 14% for the investors. I'm shouting to the world, give me money. I'll manage your funds and earn more than 14%. Active management. Passive management, I will not earn more than 14. I will not earn less than 14. I will ensure that 14, the promise is fulfilled. Right now, I've dictated, na, the promise is never fulfilled. There are techniques by which we can ensure the promise is fulfilled. That's passive management. Passive is replicating the target. You want to score exactly 400 in CA final. Not more, not less. Okay, you want to score exactly 400. And you want to, but 400 is bad, you know, it's bad luck. Let's say you want to score 420 in CA final. Okay, there's a breathing window. And the other is you want to really beat all targets and achieve what in CA final. That's active management. So we'll study that over there also. So the entire, I like the bond chapter, you know why? Because bond chapter is really very much connected. It's not that, let's start this point. It's connected. No matter whatever we are doing since yesterday, we are doing the same point. How do we know which bonds are underpriced, which bonds are overpriced? It's the same thing going on. Okay? And then we will, when I go to risk analysis, we'll question the fact that, sir, you taught us to buy the bond based on YTM. Are you sure we'll earn the YTM? No, we are not sure. Oh, sir, there's a risk involved. What's the risk? Let's calculate, let's analyze that. We did all that. Then third portion, you told us what's the risk. You did not tell us how to tackle that. That's portfolio management, active versus passive. Okay. Then the fourth portion. So in real life, we find that 1 year yield is different, 2 year yield is different, 3 year yield is different, 4 year yield is different. But what do you do in sums? There's a 5 year bond. You calculate just one YTM. There should be five different yields. 1 year different, 2 year different, 3 year different. That's term structure. Fifth part, sir, there are some strange type of bonds which have some embedded options. Okay, you did not teach about that. That's the fifth part. If you revise it continuously, you'll find bond is the easiest to revise. It is a great cohesiveness as compared to other topics where all at once the entire thing changes. Okay. So let's start. So you have written the promise is generally not fulfilled to be elaborated in the risk analysis portion, bracket close, full stop. Para change. Realized yield dash, look at the past tense, write down dash, look at the past tense in the phrase. Look at the past tense in the phrase. Past tense in the phrase dash. Parachange, first bullet, you bought the bond at P0. You bought the bond at P0. You got such and such cash flows. You got such and such cash flows. You understanding the tone which I am speaking? You reinvested the cash flows at such and such rate. You reinvested the cash flows at such and such rate. Okay, they will tell us, right, what rate? You sold the bond at such price. Bullets over. After that, parachange. Story over. What did you earn per annum? What did you earn per annum? Now, since I'm not wanting to compromise while teaching the batch at all, therefore I'll also tell you one thing. Active managers, they do what? They do scenario analysis, which means, okay, I'll buy the bond now at P0. I will hold it for 7 years, future. I will get such and such cash flows. I think I can reinvest at this rate. I think after 7 years I can sell at this price. What yield will I earn? So that way it is realized yield only. They're trying to create a scenario for the future and then calculate the yield. The math is same as realized yield, although you can argue, say it's future, future, future. Doesn't matter. The stuff is same. Scenario one. Scenario two. No, no, no. I will hold it for 6 years. I'll reinvest at this rate. I'll sell at this price. What is the realized yield? So realized yield, although I've dictated as a past tense, it can also be asked in a scenario analysis. In a scenario analysis, scenario one, if this happens, what's the yield? No, if this happens, what's the yield? I am not able to dictate that part. That will make the notes confusing. Okay? Para change. Please draw the number line. Mark 0, 1, 2, 7, 8, 9, 10. P0. C. Coupon plus face value. I hope you're okay. This is okay with you? Now, you will reinvest all these cash flows. Okay, reinvest. I hope you're fine. I'm assuming that you're selling the bond after 7 years. So you'll reinvest all the cash flows till the seventh year compounding. Now the price P7 will be the present value of this. I hope you're okay. When you sell after 7 years, what's the price? Present value of the 8th year, 9th year, 10th year. So, this is inflow. Outflow, I hope you are fine. So, outflow equal to inflow divided by 1 plus r power 7. Beautiful. Okay, outflow, the P0 equal to the inflow divided by 1 plus r power 7. The only dissatisfaction right now would be that I have not used numbers, which I will use. But the designing is so good. I have shown that we have purchased a 10-year bond, sold it after 7 years. So what did we do of the cash flows? We reinvested it. Calculate. What did you do? You sold the bond. Calculate the price. So what did you get it? Get the end? Inflow. What did you invest? Outflow. Outflow equal to inflow by 1 plus r power 7. It's perfect. Correct? I am going to take an example. Don't worry about it. Write down. Example. You bought a 10-year bond. You bought a 10-year bond 7 years ago. You bought a 10-year bond 7 years ago when the market yield was 11%. When the market yield was 11%, full stop. The bond has a 12% coupon. The bond has a 12% coupon, comma, 1000 face value. And 1000 face value. 12% coupon and 1000 face value. 12% coupon and 1000 face value. Full stop. Immediately after buying the bond, immediately after buying the bond, comma, yield went up to 14%. Yield went up to 14%, and so you kept on reinvesting, and so you kept on reinvesting, and so you kept on reinvesting. You kept on reinvesting all intermediate cash flows. You kept on reinvesting all intermediate cash flows. You kept on reinvesting all intermediate cash flows at 14%. You kept on reinvesting all intermediate cash flows at 14%. All intermediate cash flows at what? 14%. Full stop. You sold the bond now. You sold the bond now at 14% yield. You sold the bond now at 14% yield. You sold the bond now at 14% yield. At 14% yield. Full stop. Calculate your realized yield. Calculate your realized yield. Calculate your realized yield. Calculate your realized yield. Okay. So let me draw the number line again. This time with number 0, 1, 2, dash, 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 7, 8, 9, 10. Please draw. Price P0. So we'll have to calculate this. I will calculate this. It's very easy to calculate now because when we bought the bond, the yield was 11. So you have to just do the DCF with the help of 11%. Now you got 120 first year, 120 second year, 120 seventh year, and 8th year 120 still standing, 9th year 120 still standing, 10th year it's 120 plus 1000. You understanding each part of it? Now you kept on reinvesting all the cash flows at 14%, it's given in the sum. I hope you were paying attention when I was dictating. That's great news, you are reinvesting at 14%, whereas the yield was 11%. So you gained on the reinvestment front, because YTM assumes you'll be able to reinvest at 11. Now you sold the bond, P7, but this time you were sad while selling the bond, because P7 was the present value of the remaining cash flows at what rate? 14. So the yield went up, the price came down. So you gained on the reinvestment, you lost on the price. Total inflow, we will calculate. I have not calculated. Total inflow, something. Okay, are you required to draw this diagram in the exam? Not at all. Are you allowed to draw? Yes, why not? Or at least in your mind. Okay. So I'm supposed to calculate this outflow and this inflow. Without this, I can't do anything. Step 1, P0, please calculate P0 by the tone, by that tone, coupon into PVIF plus redemption into PVIF. Do it please. So I hope you are doing P0 equal to 120 into PVAF. Okay, 120 into PVAF, bracket, what rate? 11% was the rate when we bought the bond. When we bought the bond, the yield was 11. It's clearly written. You can't complain about the English language in the sum. 120 PVAF, 11%, comma, 10, not 7. It was a 10-year bond. 11%, 10 plus 1000 into PVIF, 11%, 10. Okay, 120 into PVIF, 11%, 10 plus 1000 into PVIF, 11%, 10. Yes, please. Tell me the answer. 1058.9. Are you okay with this more or less? Okay, 1058.9. 1058.9. You should also be okay. Why premium? Because the coupon rate is higher. The coupon rate is 12. Whenever the coupon rate is higher, it's a premium bond. So you bought at this price. Step 2. Future value of reinvested coupon. Future value of reinvested coupon at 14% at the end of 7 years. Future value of reinvested coupon at 14% at the end of 7 years. Future value of reinvested coupon at 14% at the end of 7 years. Future value of reinvested coupon at 14% at the end of 7 years. At the end of 7 years. So in that case, just one second, please draw. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Please draw this. This is 120, 120, 120, 120, 120, 120, 120. The seventh 120 remains 120. I hope you are fine. Because how can you reinvest that? The story ends over there. The sixth 120 is 120 into 1.14. Yes, please. 120 into 1.14. 136.8. The fifth 120 is 120 into 1.14 square. Now wait, please, apply common sense. You can do 136.8 into 1.14. You can do 136.8 into 1.14. So the calculation is so easy. The previous one into 1.14. Because you want to do square, but into 1.14 was already done. So 136.8 into 1.14. Yes, please. 155.95. 155.95. Once again, please. 120 into 1.14 cube. You should do 155.95 into 1.14. 177.79. Then 120 into 1.14 power 4, which is actually 177.79 into 1.14. Can I have it from you? 202.67. Next. 120 into 1.14 power 5, which is actually 202.67 into 1.14. 231.05. And the first one, 120 into 1.14 power 6. 120 into 1.14 power 6. 263.39 total, okay, including the seventh 120. So 120 plus 136.8 plus 155.95 plus 177.79 plus 202.67 plus 231.05 plus 263.39. Yes. What is it? What is it? Can I have it from you? 1287.65. Okay, now just one thing I wanted to mention. In SFM, also in CA Inter, IPCC FM, we don't have to calculate the future value at all. We always calculate the present value. Therefore, we teachers do not focus to teach you how to calculate the future value of annuity. We never, nobody focuses. Okay? But in South region and all, they do CA Foundation very religiously. Okay? Every day 8 hours tuition. That way. They may remember, some of them, what is the formula for future value of annuity. So if anybody remembers the formula for future value of annuity, instead of doing all this, it could have been done by formula. I will not advise you all to adhere to the formula because it's not required. Future value of annuity doesn't come to use. And if it comes to use, we are better off doing this way. But those people may judge me that, sir, we could have done it so easily. Okay, the formula A by I, 1 plus I to the power N minus 1. Okay, this is the future value of annuity. A is 120, I is 0.14, 1.14 to the power 7 minus 1. You can just try for the purpose of trying. 120 by 0.14, 1.14 to the power 7 minus 1. Please try. On the calci, you have to do 1.14 power 7. 1.14 to the power 7. Then minus 1. Then whatever you get, that into 120 by 0.14. Fine. So my reason for mentioning that, because when you are teaching a diverse audience, some or the other person remembers this stuff and he will feel that sir did it so inefficiently. Okay, because efficiency means we should have done it as the red portion. Okay, it's coming to the same figure, 1287 point something. Okay, so I mentioned yes, you are allowed to do it by the annuity formula. I've also waited long for anybody to copy if they wanted to. Okay. Step 3. Look at the number line again. Step 3, please look at the number line again. We want to calculate P7 because you want to sell the bond after 7 years. So when you sell the bond, you will get the present value of the remaining cash flow discounted at the market rate. The market rate is what? 14. So you know what we have to do. Price of the bond is coupon amount into annuity factor, redemption amount into discounting factor, the same formula. Okay, please do it. Selling price at the end of 7 years. Selling price at the end of 7 years, that is P7. Selling price at the end of 7 years, that is P7. Selling price at the end of 7 years, that is P7. P7. Selling price at the end of 7 years, that is P7 equal to 120 into PVAF, 14%, comma, 3 years are left, plus 1000 into PVIF, 14%, comma, 3. So we will be sad to see this because when we calculated P0, we used 11% market yield. Now we are using 14, so the price is falling. If yield goes, the price falls. Please calculate. Yes. Yes, please. 9. 50. 3. Okay, 5.7 or 5.9, whatever. Some difference will happen. 953.59, the selling price. Step 4. Total inflow at T equal to 7. T equal to 7 means at the end of 7th year. Equal to step 2 plus step 3. Correct? If you are not clear with it, you should look at your diagram again. Number line. All the money we got on the 1st, 2nd, 3rd year, we went on reinvesting step 2. And we sold the bond, that was step 3. Whatever total money we got, please add and tell me. Please add and tell me. 2241.24. Story over. 2241.24 we got after 7 years. And how much had we invested in step 1? 1058.9? 9? Or 1058.9? It's like a normal time value of money sum. You put 1058.9 in a bank today and after 7 years you take back 2241.24. There is some return you got because you invested 1058 in a bank today and after 7 years you get 2241. What's the hidden rate? That's IRR. Step 5. realized yield outflow equal to inflow. Outflow equal to inflow. What was the outflow? 1058.9 equal to 2241.24 divided by 1 plus r to the power what? 7. So r is equal to 2241.24 divided by 1058.9 to the power 1 by 7 minus 1. 2241.24 divided by 1058.9 whole to the power 1/7 minus 1. Dirty power please. 2241.24 divided by 1058.9. Square root 12 times. Then minus 1. Then divide by 7. Then plus 1. Then into equal to 12 times. Then whatever you get, minus 1 equal to into 100. Yes. 11.31%. 11.31%. Okay, this is the realized yield. Okay, 11.31% realized yield. If there were sums which come regularly on this, I would have done 10 such sums. Okay, because it never comes. Therefore, we have done one master sum. You have to understand in SFM, some topics are done just one sum. Why? Because sir means to say, it never comes. Therefore, you have to go just concept-wise with one practice. Some topics come so many times, we keep on doing sums after sums after sums after sums on them. Okay? But if you wanted sums after sums on all topics, it will be an incompletable syllabus. Not only from a class point of view, but also from your home point of view. Okay? So this was realized yield.